A dangerous photo.
It's Friday afternoon. James and his sister Emma are in Cambridge during the day.
They are looking at the beautiful old buildings of this university city.
This place is very, very beautiful. Emma has a camera with her. She likes to take pictures, and sometimes they are really good. But sometimes they aren't very good, and James laughs at them. It is 5 o'clock. Emma and James are going home now. They are tired after their long day. They are in the garden near the bus station. "Let's have a last photo of you," says Emma. "Oh no, not again," says James. "Come on," says Emma. "It's the last one. I want to finish the film in my camera." "Oh, all right," says James. He stands in front of the flowers. "Look at me," says Emma, and takes a photo. A man with a big rucksack on his back walks between Emma and James. "Oh no," says Emma. "Now I've got a picture of that man, not of you, James." The man looks at Emma. He is angry. He goes across the road without a word. "That man isn't very nice, is he?" says James. "No," says Emma. And that was the last picture on the film, too. The man with the rucksack on his back goes into the bus station. He has got sunglasses and a blue hat. "Come on," says James. "Let's find our bus." They go into the bus station. "Look," says James. "There's that man again. He's getting into that bus. He's going to Aberdeen. That's in Scotland." "Good," says Emma. "Far from here and far from me." She is angry with the man. 3 days later, on Tuesday, Emma has got her photos from the shop. "Look at these," she says to James. "They're the photos of us in Cambridge." "Oh, these are all very good," says James. "But not this last one," says Emma. "Look, it's that man with the rucksack. In the photo, the man is in front of James. You cannot see James behind the man's rucksack." "Wait a minute," says James. "I know that face. It's in the newspaper." "Have you got it?" "Today's newspaper?" says Emma. "Yes, it's here." "Why?" "Yes, here he is. Look at this picture," says James. Emma looks at the photo in the newspaper. "Who's that?" she asks. "It says in the paper his name's Alan Rook," says James. "And he works in a bank in London. But on Monday morning, yesterday morning, no Alan Rook. The people at the bank don't know where he is. And they say he's got £100,000 with him. The police are looking for him, too." "Who's that?" she asks. "It says in the paper his name's Alan Rook," says James. "And he works in a bank in London. But on Monday morning, yesterday morning, no Alan Rook. The people at the bank don't know where he is. And they say he's got £100,000 with him. The police are looking for him, too. Look, says James. I'm putting dark glasses and a 2-day beard on the man in this photo. Now I'm drawing a hat on his head. See? Now look at the two pictures. You're right, says Emma. It's him. It's Alan Rook. Come on, says James. Let's take these pictures to the police. At the police station, Emma and James speak to a policeman. They put Emma's photo and the newspaper on the table and they tell their story. That's Alan Rook, says the policeman. In Cambridge at 5 o'clock on Saturday. The big question is, where is he now? We think we know. He's in Scotland, in Aberdeen, says Emma. Or he's near there. They tell the policeman about the man and the bus to Aberdeen. He's got a rucksack and a tent on his back in the photo, says the policeman. He isn't living in a hotel. He's camping. If we're lucky, he's still in Scotland. I must make a telephone call. The policeman telephones the police station in Aberdeen. Alan Rook's in Scotland, he says. We think he's camping near Aberdeen. He's got a short beard now. The next day, the police in Aberdeen find Alan Rook in a tent in the mountains near Aberdeen. The money from the bank is in his rucksack. The next morning, Emma and James's story is in all the newspapers. There is Emma's photo of Alan Rook at the bus station. There is a picture of James and Emma, too. In the newspaper it says, camera girl gets photo of Rook. Police in Aberdeen find bank money. The people at the bank are very happy. They give Emma and James £1,000. My last photo's a good one after all, laughs Emma. Now I can buy a very good new camera.